let's hit the red record button. Good. Numbers on the screen. Are you going to flash? Good. All right. Okay. It's 4 o'clock in the morning, Pacific Standard Time. And these are, you know. This is G-sharp 2. This is the key of F sharp. G sharp. G sharp is the second note in the key of F. This is F1 or F sharp 1. F sharp. It's the second note in the key. G sharp. F sharp is the first note. Okay, a little reminder, this is how we know we're in the right spot. We're all familiar with that song, right? Hopefully. It's an Illuminati song, but it's the only thing we have really that's widely known that people can relate to, so we can teach music at least. G sharp 2, right? What am I doing? I'm doing a G sharp 2 arpeggio. And I threw in a little target note practice in there for a little change up. A little F1 and a little F sharp 2 for a change up. Just to give it a little flavor. This is our emotion right here. This is the feeling that's going through our bodies right now. It's vibrating. It vibrates at so many times a minute. Since it's probably about 400 around there, around 400 times a minute, it's making the body vibrate. So it makes the body feel a certain way. Landed on the F sharps or the F7 and I just held it. So once we start holding it, then a new feeling starts coming. When we hold it, we get a new feeling, right? Y'all know about holding things, right? A whole new feeling comes on, right? Yeah. That's what you call some aggressive digging, man. Passionate, aggressive digging. I was digging so hard, my pick flicked right out of my hands. But anyway, that's a whole new feeling. It's a whole new emotion. It's different from that number two emotion. Okay, this F right here that I was playing, instead of around 400, it's probably around 375 vibrations a minute, because it's a lower note. It has more slack in it. It's looser. It's not as tight. If I bring it up, it's tighter. Take it down, it's looser. More slack. More play in it. More slop. Right. Now what's this? That's intergalactic ascension. That's is just a fancy way for saying it's the next octave. It's the same note. Okay, whenever we play two notes in a row, right, two different notes, the relationship between those two notes is known as an interval. It's an interval. That's why I called it intervalactic. And I went from a low note to the high octave. So that's going low to high is ascending. So I called it intervalactic ascension. It's the same note, it's the same feeling, but the feeling's a little different now. Because it's really tighter now. It's way tight. It's a way higher note. But it's based around the same feeling. Sends them. When we start looking for them, the Creator has already sent the melody. We just grab onto it. It just drops right into our mind. Takes a little practice, probably. You know, it takes a little time to spend on it, and you know. What note is that? Well, let's see if we can find it. There's its octave right there. One of its octaves. I know how to find octaves. My ear is trained at it. An octave is the easiest interval of all the intervals to find. It's the easiest of all ones to recall in our minds. As a side note. I was to try to do like an octave, like an intervalactic relationship between a note and a different note. All right, I need lots of practice on that one. I'm still figuring that out, man. But the octave to find the same note, the octave is the exact same note. Higher or lower pitch, and that's the easiest one to find. It's easiest to find the exact same note in our minds, to recall it in our minds and to sing it. I can do it just like that. It's like clockwork every time. But to find another one, if someone was to ask me, hey man, can you do a fifth? Can you do a third? Can you do a major second? I'd be like, I'd have to play it first. Dun dun, there's a major fifth. That's a power chord, by the way. All heavy metal power chords are made up of a perfect fifth. Or it's a fifth. It's called a fifth. Perfect fifth. Can you sing me a perfect fifth? I'd have to play it on my guitar first. Dun 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 dun. There it is. Dun 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 dun. Can you play me a? Can you play me an octave? No problem. Can you sing me an octave right out of your mind? No problem. I can do it every time, just like clockwork. So what was this note? There it was. Well, let's see. Let's number them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That was a 5 note. Do, deer, female, deer. Okay. So I know my finger patterns. Okay. If we don't know them, then we'd have to learn them. But since how I know them, I just made quick reference. 1, 2, 3. 3 notes per string. 4, 5, 6. 3 notes per string. 7, 1, 2. 3 notes per string. 3, 4, 5. There it is. It's a 5 note. This is the octave. That's the number 5 emotion, by the way. There it is. It has its own feeling as we sit there and hold it. Okay, but what gives it its real feeling? It's the fact that we play all the other notes in the key with it, right? Or against it. 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, and I've played the scale, okay, this is a bit of a prerequisite for beginning to have melodies just drop into the mind. Now my mind is automatically zeroed in on the sound of the notes. And when I play that one note and hold it at five, now my mind's gonna go on automatic pilot and it'll start dropping melodies in from the Creator, from the Most High. Just drops melodies right in there. Number one, emotion. Number five.